Finally, the next studio tour. Today we'll visit the Digital Bunch, based in Warsaw, Poland. They're not a typical RV studio. They combine 3D with software development, which makes them unique in the field. Let's get to know the team. This studio tour is brought to you by Chaos Group. If you enjoy it, thank them in the comments section.
Hi, my name is Dagmar. I'm the founder of Digital Bunch, and I started in 2019. My background is actually in software development. I used to be a project manager. I got inspired by 3D by looking at augmented reality and what the AR kits released by Apple could offer. I knew that augmented reality was the future. It turns out that this bet was very relevant because now we're seeing that this technology is taking over. I've been very fortunate in my journey to have met Alex. He became my business partner and we're doing the whole operation together.
My background is the software development. This is how I started. I fall in love in startups. So I started my journey like almost 10 years ago. Then I met Dagmara, who showed me how amazing the 3D world can be as well. So I got interested, got intrigued. And here I am right now trying to, well, incorporate different software practices in 3D development.
I think I value him the most for just his critical thinking. It does really help. Building something together that like is such a big project, it just helps so much to have someone that you actually trust. The fact of combining software and CG actually gives us this competitive edge, which is being able to create interactive experiences or being able to write scripts or being able to think about what we do in a way where we can automate certain processes or just kind of think about it in terms of like the tools that we use and the setup that we have.
We have VR, we have AR. I cannot wait for AR glasses that Apple presented, for example, and like give the users the proper 3D experience to use software and like fully immerse the users in the 3D worlds.
We're already talking about creating some demos in that space. I think it's going to be like a huge opportunity for CG studios out there, but also architects who will be ready to design whole spaces in 3D for a completely new platform.
The upcoming years will bring a lot of possibilities for studios like ours, which are pretty rare because we combine the software capabilities and 3D skills. So we are super excited to finally use our skills to the fullest and show the users how the true VR experience can look like. Another step is the upcoming trend of 3D on the web. As the hardware is getting better and better every other year, recently Google added a new feature that the web developers can actually start using more of the GPU finally. We were pretty limited, now the limits are gone. So I'm really hoping that here in Digital Bunch we'll be able to help our customers to create wonderful 3D experiences on the web soon.
How do you approach artists' progress? Do you have any special form of evaluating their improvement and how they can build their career in your studio?
An interesting framework that we created to assess artists. It was actually developed because we wanted to make sure that we're very transparent about what it takes to be a junior, a mid, a senior artist, and we just want people to know very well what they need to do in order to progress in their career. So we identified several areas that to us are very important in the skill set of a 3D artist. And we have both technical aspects of this, but also skills that are required. And all of this is defined by the level of seniority of every artist. This is like a cheat sheet that artists can use to be able to advance their careers.
There are lots of talks about burnout nowadays. Do you have any solutions to prevent this situation?
We know that it takes a lot to keep this passion ignited, and we only want to work with passionate people. So our goal really is to make sure that the conditions and the environment that creative enough and supports their growth and development. And for that reason, we have sometimes situations where someone will start their career in CG with architecture, but will want to switch. Mikoy is actually one of a great example of an artist who started in architecture, but then moved on to the product and SFX team.
I moved to VFX and product team like 2 years ago. The main reason because I want to grow up as an artist and explore new things like simulation, product visualization. Now I'm preparing a model of human face for eyes surgery animation. We will have a face with a different kind of eyeballs, and we need to show different eye diseases on the eyeballs. It's kind of funny to learn new things, new tools, because it's kind of challenging when you need to do something that you didn't do, for example, in your past, and you need to, you know, to achieve results in a short of time.
At the beginning, I was a 2D designer. One day, Alex and Dagmara came to me and said that, hey, there's some cool software called Figma, and why don't you try to use it? That's the beginning of my career path, actually. I'm super happy that UX and UI is something very similar to my personality, and it's a great thing that combines logic and creativity. So I'm super happy that I can work in a place and in things that I really love.
When running any kind of organization, the very important aspect are people, their vibe, their communication style, and lots of other aspects. This is what we value very, very much, and this is something that is super important for us. That's why whenever we are screening candidates, we spend a lot of time trying to see if the candidate, potential candidate, check all the boxes. In our work environment, well, I, to be honest, love all the people with whom I work with.
I'm a Mexican architect. I've been working as an architect, but then I decided to jump into a 3D world. That's when I moved from Mexico to Poland. I just saw that in 3D, I could do much more things than in architecture. Like when you're building stuff, there's some limits. In 3D, you start like creating whatever is in your mind, and that's beautiful about it. And when I came working in Poland, I had like a really low knowledge about all this 3D and visualization. And during this process, I've been working here. I learned like many things had helped me to get better and improve in anything, which is really cool.
I have been working as a 3D graphic designer for several years. I'm loving it, multitude of possibilities it gives, and the fact that you are unlimited by your imagination. Currently I'm working on an application of interior in Unreal, where I'm building blueprints to make the experience interactive. I'm also making Instagram and Facebook filters. I'm very much looking forward to build things in new platforms like Vision Pro.
Mexico moving to Poland. Interesting. Do you like living here?
Yeah, I don't like that much the weather of Poland if you compare it to Mexico, but it's lovely. I was scared before coming here, like thinking that people might be more cold and not that open, but I find so like a surprise that people are like nice, and I enjoy that. It's a good atmosphere, and I miss the food too.
How do the ARVIS teams work in your studio? Do the teams have any structure?
We have several people working together on a specific project, and typically these teams shift and change, so you get to work with pretty much everyone from the whole team. And every time that a new project starts, we pick a team lead who is responsible for the consistency of the images. They are supposed to check if all the materials are there and if there are any questions from the team. So that person is a different person every time, so everyone gets to be a team lead. We typically choose more senior artists, but it's also an opportunity to check if a person actually wants to pursue a more managerial career and if they want to actually take on more responsibilities over time.
Do you incorporate any fun activities in the office?
I think as a team, we like to have a lot of fun and we like to play around with the work that we do. We don't treat ourselves seriously, and I guess that's what leads to a lot of like just funny takes on our work. One of them is that it's something that not a lot of our clients know, but we tend to sneak in some cutouts of ourselves into the images. It's obviously something that is like an inside joke, and the people who actually know us well and who have been to our office will instantly recognize our artists in the images. But We actually wanted to give you a little something from our studio, and it's a set of cutouts of our team members that you're free to use in any of your projects and enjoy.
You'll find the links to the cutouts in the description below this video. What render engine do you use?
As a studio, we are using current render engine, and I'm happy to say that we are really satisfied with the result it produces. I'm personally involved in testing of Corona software beta versions. Happy to say that we actually see the result of the feedback, and that development team actually reacting on our messages and the feedback that we are providing to them.
What was the most interesting project lately?
One of the most exciting projects that we recently were involved in was at this tower in Warsaw. And the reason why it was exciting is because we actually get to see a lot of the designs and a lot of the architecture that will be built in our city much earlier than anyone else gets to see it. We feel like we're shaping the city and the environment that we live in, and that we actually have some sort of impact on this.
And one of the most exciting things during the process was like that rendering was printed in billboards. Every day we can see the result of our work, like how the tower built.
It's just really great to feel involved in something big that is happening in the area.
You chose a field that is not exactly in line with your background. Do you see this as an obstacle?
Because I'm actually not a CG artist myself, or I'm not an architect, I do have to question a lot of things. It sort of protects me from this bias that other senior artists may experience, where they think that the method that they chose and that they learned is the best. We've actually built lots of processes and improved them over time because I'm just not scared to change things over if they don't work. I think it also creates like a better communication sort of framework within the team, because we just tend to talk a lot more, and I don't think there are any stupid questions really. Everything can be discussed, and there's like an open line of communication between all team members in this industry. We're very passionate about what we do, and we tend to leave a part of our soul in the images that we create or the animations that we prepare. It's sometimes hard to kind of get the right perspective and like a distance from the actual feedback that is given from clients or from other team members. I think from a psychological level, it's also important to treat it as a way to improve your work and not as something personal.
What other types of projects do you work on?
On a daily basis, besides like being involved in 3D stuff, I'm highly involved in leading the software team and creating custom software for our mostly US-based clients, mostly startups from the Bay Area, but also other clients across Europe, bringing the new mobile applications, but also complex web applications.
I think this ability to have multiple areas that we focus on, so CG but also software and interactive, actually helps us to be more immune to any market crises. We actually have clients in automotive, FMCG, and in other industries, so to us it just makes us less vulnerable to stuff like this. And the second thing is that we're able to just do more R&D, think about what the products of the future are going to look like, and build our business strategy based on not just this first horizon, but also what's sort of round the corner and what we anticipate is going to be the next big thing. We're not really scared of developments like AI. We think that it's something that we need to embrace, and we need to use it and be smart about implementing it in our workflow, but then kind of use the building blocks to create something much bigger, because we'll now have this ability to do that. A great thing that happens with the development of technology and both hardware and software is the fact that you can achieve more with a much smaller studio. So an endeavor that used to be filming a whole commercial now can actually be done by three people, four people, and there are these pizza teams that are able to achieve amazing quality and amazing results. It's going to mean that the costs of production and the complexity of production are going to go down. I think it's just a matter of our creativity and how we can leverage the skills and the tools that we have to offer more to other industries.
How do you communicate with clients?
Because of my background in advertising, I had experience with managing the clients, the timelines, the budget, so it was like big benefit for me while I transferred to DB. So when it comes to our workflow with our clients, we always try to be flexible because each project is different, each client is different, and you have to establish your own language with them based on their needs. So when we start a new project, we always check what the goal of the client is and what is the purpose of each project, if it's marketing, if it's competition, if it's like early concept, because each of them has their own set of rules. So we always try to adapt to the type of the project.
Whenever we talk to clients, we try to play the role of a visual consultant. So we don't just do what they ask us to do, we actually ask about the purpose of the images or the animations, the goal that they're trying to achieve. That then has an impact on the formats that they need and the final output. So we just use our experiences and our know-how to guide the clients.
What would you say to artists who want to set up their own company?
I think that if I were to give a piece of advice to such a person, I would say just don't do it. And the reason is because being a great artist is one thing, but then running a whole operation is another thing, and it requires all of the things that are very mundane and very problematic, like looking for clients, pitching, invoicing, chasing after invoices. It's organizing things, it's fixing things when they break, and at a scale that, you know, is much greater. And I think whilst it can be rewarding, definitely, I think if you're a good artist, you will be able to work anywhere you want and do the projects that you want and be involved in stuff that just fulfills you from a creative perspective. Just the managerial side is very often undermined in just running a company in general. It's quite stressful. It just requires like a lot of time and attention. So then you're not able to devote that time and attention to the creative side, and it's just hard to combine those two things. But if you really want to do it, and despite everything, you're still willing to set up your own thing, go for it.
Thank you so much for the visit. It was a great time. I hope you guys enjoyed it too. And you'll give the team some love in the comments. See you soon. Bye bye.